So, welcome to another episode of Racing to Learn, where we're a nonprofit to get kids excited about math and science.
Thank you for that wonderful introduction. All right, on the bench today, we've got a couple of trucks. I would say 2.5 trucks. We've got our ECX Ruckus that, we didn't buy it as a brushless. Actually, we did buy it as a brushless. Not sure if it was originally one. But you can check out the entire playlist for our ECX Ruckus two-wheel drive brushless in the video description. We've got a Torment on the bench here too. They basically share the same chassis just have different wheels and tires, different bumpers. The Torment has these side bash guards there because it's a short course truck versus the ECX Ruckus, which is a full-blown monster truck. So we are continuing our rebuild of this truck because unfortunately, a new driver, my son's friend, drove this for the first time and basically went full throttle. Kids will usually go full throttle on these trucks until they learn how to, not go full throttle, which takes a little bit of time, but their natural instinct is just to pull on that trigger full blast. And my, is it fun, right? Especially with a brushless truck like this, to be able to witness that acceleration and that power. It just went full speed into a concrete set of stairs. And so we're dealing with the aftermath now. It basically shattered the chassis, which is, we've never broken a chassis on these. We have a couple of these ECX two-wheel drives, two Torments, two Ruckuses. We've had more in the past. We've sold some off just to make space in the garage, but we've never broken a chassis. We actually received this as a donation, this shattered chassis. You could see where it broke, basically in the same spot here. And the previous owner of this looks like they tried to glue it. Maybe some JB Weld in there. That looks like JB Weld. That usually is not going to fare too well in the long term. It broke again, right? Essentially, with these chassis are made out of probably nylon. Yeah, it's probably nylon. I can't tell. I'm not a plastics expert or a material science expert, but gluing these, it might be a temporary fix, but it's never going to be as strong as it was originally. So our chassis, if you want to take a look at the damage, broke in a very similar fashion here. It was a front end collision. So we'll take a look. It basically broke on the opposite side here so we could fuse these two halves together. Here is a clean chassis. This was actually supposed to be the basis of our ultimate Ruckus build. So this is a pretty clean chassis here. We ditched this when we bought an already built one off of eBay. So we got this truck. It already had the brushless system in it here. We kept the motor. We swapped in a $14 OC day unit, which was basically an exact copy of the I'm totally forgetting, Ghoul RC. These Chinese manufacturers, I shouldn't say manufacturers, but there are a whole bunch of companies that manufacture these, and they will just a reseller or whatnot, like Ghoul RC, will just put their branding on it and resell it. So the OEMs are probably original equipment manufacturer. That's the person that actually makes these things. There may be a handful, I don't know, but a whole bunch of them come out looking very similar except for the lettering on the side. And this has been a pretty reliable ESC. You can't really complain for $14 for a brushless ESC, electronic speed control. The motor, I'm guessing that this was a Ghoul RC brand too. We basically got these with the truck, along with these beautiful Proline Super Swampers, 2.8-inch Super Swampers. Basically, we got this truck off of eBay, and we didn't bother We didn't bother building this chassis, which was going to be our ultimate ECX Ruckus. So in the last episode, we were doing some, we were breaking down the chassis a little bit here, but we stripped one of these screws. Now that is not a factory screw. Unfortunately, from the factory, the ECX cars come with Phillips heads. If you've been in the hobby for any amount of time, you know Phillips is bad. We stripped this one. Actually, I can get it out with a driver. That's nice, because the hand driver wasn't working. I was wondering if we'd have to break this apart. Definitely not using these replacement screws anymore. Really like the packaging on the ECX two-wheel drives. They're very well designed, much more modern than a Traxxas slash or Stampede design. That was actually the truck that got me back into the hobby, the Traxxas slash. So we have one that we converted to a monster truck. We'll include links to that in the video description as well. But you know, we had to throw a whole bunch of upgrades on that truck to even get it reliable. Versus this truck, it needed a couple of upgrades. Again, you can refer to the video description for those exact upgrades, but you know, just a handful of upgrades, and it's been pretty bulletproof. It's definitely the longest running truck in our collection in terms of durability. I'm gonna take this half chassis and put it off to the side. We'll work on the back half later after we get the front half situated. So we've got this front half. We're going to move all the components, or you know, just whatever components we see fit, over to this other chassis here. So this is like a jigsaw puzzle. You know, basically, what are the least possible pieces we can remove? Definitely, we're going to remove everything. Yeah, we'll start with the bumper. I'll do less talking, more wrenching, so to speak. So, we'll take this front bumper off, and I'm just going to lay these screws down close to, or in a cluster with, the actual part that they go with. The bumpers on these Ruckuses, super durable. You don't need an aftermarket bumper. We like to run the larger Torment bumper. It's just got a larger front surface area here, but everything is super well designed. Of course, ECX comes out of the Horizon Hobbies line of or Horizon Hobbies. It's not a line, it's a company. So I'm gonna grab. Really like how they use captured mounts here. You know, like this bumper mount, you put a driver in here, you pop out. Oh, I think I need something thinner. I used a paper clip last time. So basically the pin in here is captured, which is super nice. You're not gonna have screws falling out. You just push out the pin here from a hole on the other side, and there we go. We'll leave that here because we're going to be doing that again. All right, and you can see just how this comes together here. I'm just trying to get, actually, I probably didn't even have to remove the bumper, but it just makes life easier. I've just got to get this screw out. So looks like the previous owner used a collection of hex, and standard screws, no big deal, but we'll probably standardize on something here. Actually, this might be even a good chance to switch over to stainless hardware. I'm gonna put this over here. Okay, just two more screws over there. All right, so this shock tower is intact. Oh, the screws are kind of hard to get to. I might have to use a manual screwdriver here. Just so that I don't have to futz with taking that bumper off. Okay, it is coming loose. Actually, this will be a perfect time to switch over to some stainless hardware that we've got. We bought a whole box of 4mm and 3mm stainless nuts and bolts. And so we just might use this opportunity to switch over. All right. There we go. Cool, so we got the remnants of that front chassis out. Toss this. This is the front suspension. It looks like we've got to replace this piece as well, because this is where the suspension arm held down, and that got torn out during the impact. So we will have to replace this bulkhead. It's probably called a bulkhead as well. Or we might just use whatever's on this chassis. We might actually just do that. We'll see what is less work. While we've got this in hand here, you can see some of the upgrades that we've done. These are non-standard. These are actually rear bearing carriers being used in the front. There's an excellent video that we have in that playlist that details this. Now this is because and I don't have a stock one lying around here, but the shoulder screws that are usually used to hold in the front bearing carriers, they just fall out. Real pain in the butt because they don't have enough bite into that plastic or enough threads going in. They'll just work their way loose and fall out during the most inopportune times. So this uses a capture design where we have a long 3mm bolt going all the way through the C-hub, through the bearing carrier, and out through the other side secured by a nut. So that is not going anywhere. None of our other suspension components just the bulkhead was damaged and the chassis was damaged. Pretty good for probably a 40, 45 mile impact into solid concrete. So let us know what you guys think. We're going to continue this video series, just moving our parts over. You can see the RPM bell crank here, steering bell crank. It replaces the stock servo saver, which is kind of notorious for being vague and wobbling around when you're in reverse. So we got that along with this truck when we bought it off of eBay, along with full RPM lower control arms, front and rear. So again, let us know what you guys think in the comments. Like, comment, subscribe, hit that notification button, because we're putting out a lot more videos now that we're in a shelter in place here in California. So thanks again for watching, and we will catch you next time.